Hello students, today I'll start with the law of reciprocal proportions. According to this law, okay, let us consider that A parts of an element A combine with C parts of another element C. Again, let us consider that B parts of element B combines separately with C parts of element C. Let us consider that in the combination of A and C, we will get a compound X, and in the combination of B and C, we will get a compound Y. Here A and B separately combines with a fixed mass of C. We will notice that the ratio of the masses of A is to B will be small a is to small b, since it is A parts by mass of A and B parts by mass of B, so the ratio of masses of element A is to element B will be A is to B, where A and B are the parts by mass of A and cap of elements A and B respectively. Okay, now according to this law, it states that if these elements A and B separately together combine with each other, where I have taken A parts of A by mass and B parts of B by mass, then the ratio of their masses will either be A is to B or XA is to YB, where X and Y are the two simple whole numbers. Okay, I repeat the entire explanation once again. If I take A parts by mass of element A and B parts by mass of element B, and element A and element B separately combine with a fixed mass of element C, then we are getting two compounds, capital X and capital Y respectively. So the ratio of the masses of element A and element B will be small a is to small b. According to this law, if A parts by mass of element A and B parts by mass of element B combine together directly, then the ratio of their masses will also be either A is to B or XA is to XB, where X and Y are simple whole numbers. I will explain with an example, that will be better. Let's consider carbon combines with hydrogen to form methane, and oxygen combines with the same fixed mass of hydrogen to form water. In methane, since the atomic mass of carbon is 12 and the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1, since there are 4 hydrogens, so 1 into 4, 4. In methane, 4 parts of hydrogen combine with 12 parts of carbon. Here, the atomic mass of oxygen is 16. And that of hydrogen is 1. There, since there are 2 hydrogens, so 2 into 1, 2. two parts of hydrogen combine with 16 parts of oxygen. So if we reduce it to simpler form, then we can get that one part of hydrogen combined with three parts of carbon, and here if we reduce to simplest form, then one part of hydrogen combined with eight parts of oxygen. So one part of hydrogen three parts of carbon, eight parts of oxygen. Three parts of carbon with one part of hydrogen and eight parts of oxygen with one part of hydrogen. So the ratio will be 3:8. The ratio of the masses of three parts of carbon to eight parts of oxygen that will combine with one part of hydrogen will be 3:8. Again, if we consider the direct combination of carbon and oxygen, then we can take two examples. One is carbon dioxide and the other is carbon monoxide. In carbon dioxide, 16 into 2, 32 parts of oxygen combined with 12 parts of carbon. And in carbon monoxide, one oxygen atom is present. So 16 parts of oxygen combined with 12 parts of carbon. So here the ratio of the masses of carbon is to oxygen will be 12:32, which if reduced to simplest ratio will be 3:8. And here the ratio of the masses of carbon and oxygen will be 12:16, which if reduced to lowest form will be 3:4. Now look at the two ratios. If we combine directly also, we are getting 3:8, which is same as predicted earlier. And if we are getting 3:4, then this is a simple whole number form of the previous predicted ratio. Okay, this is the law of reciprocal proportion. Next is, I'll come to the Gay-Lussac's law. Okay, the law of reciprocal proportion was postulated by Richter. Next, I'll come to the law, Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volumes. Okay. According to this law, under the same conditions, under the same conditions of temperature and pressure different gases react with one another in a simple ratio of their volumes and if the products are gaseous then their volumes will also remain in simple ratio with the volumes of the reacting gases. Okay, this is Gay-Lussac's law. Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volumes. This law deals with the volumes of gases. I'll come to the examples. For example, if hydrogen reacts with oxygen to give steam, here hydrogen, oxygen, steam, all are gaseous. Both the reactants are gaseous, product is also gaseous. From here, we can obtain that two volume of hydrogen will react with one volume of oxygen to give two volumes of steam. Then, under same conditions of temperature and pressure, the ratio of the volumes of hydrogen, oxygen and steam will be 2:1:2. Okay? Now, let me take another example. H2 plus hydrogen and chlorine reacts to give HCl gas. One volume of hydrogen reacts with one volume of chlorine to give two volumes of HCl gas. Then, under the same conditions of temperature and pressure, the ratio of the volumes of hydrogen, chlorine and HCl will be 1:2. Okay, here we won't write the atomic form like this. Here molecular compositions are taken. ओके. बोथ द रेशियोज आर सिंपल रेशियोज. ओके, नेक्स्ट आई विल कम टू डाल्टन्स एटॉमिक थ्योरी. डाल्टन्स एटॉमिक थ्योरी इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. The postulates of Dalton's atomic theory are important, limitations are important, modifications are important, is an important part. Dalton's atomic theory. According to him, matter is composed of tiny particles called Matter is composed of tiny particles called atoms. The second postulate is atoms are indivisible. Which means that atoms cannot be divided by physical or chemical means. The third postulate is that atoms are neither created nor destroyed. The fourth postulate is atoms of the same element are identical in all respects. In all respects means in size, mass, as well as other properties. The fifth postulate is that atoms of different elements are different in all respects. And the sixth and the final postulate that atoms take part in chemical reaction. And during a chemical reaction, they combine with one another in simple whole number ratios, such as 1:2. They take part in chemical reactions. And during the chemical reaction, they combine with each other in simple whole number ratios. Okay, these are the postulates of Dalton's atomic theory. In my next video, I'll continue with Dalton's atomic theory. I will continue with the limitations, the importance, and the modifications of Dalton's atomic theory. Thank you.